Hello everybody, SkullyBud here, and today we are embarking on a new adventure. Oh ho 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 ho! Oh! Oh, what a spawn! What a spawn! Oh, this is great! Hey guys, how's it going? SkullyBud here. Welcome back to another Minecraft Let's Play video! Ah, it's been so long! It has been so long since I've said that. Today, we are going to be starting something brand new, at least to me. It's very popular on YouTube, that's for sure, but to me, this is brand new. I have never done a proper hardcore world before, and I'm really excited about it. And I really want to put a lot of effort and work into this world. I'm so excited. You guys have no idea how cool it feels to be making videos again. I've been on a hiatus for about 1.5 years, and I didn't know if I was going to be coming back. You know, sometimes you get responsibilities, and you need to make sure that those responsibilities are taken care of before anything else. It is time to absolutely loot this village and milk these villagers of all their worth. Hear that? You hear that? I'm going to milk you. Oh, there's an ice spike biome over there. How cool. We're definitely going to get some ice eventually. All right, Mr. Farmer, what have you got? You got seeds.
You got carrots. You got me carrots. I am taking all of your carrots. Thank you very much.
And potatoes. We can make all of the baked potatoes. Oh, this is fantastic. All right, let's check out the blacksmith. We got some armor right off the bat. You guys have no idea how good this feels. This is an epic spawn. All right, we'll take this grindstone too. I know we're going to need that eventually. And we're going to need you sugarcane, and you cows. We are going to need you. All right, we've already got like a great start on things that we need. But here's the question. We got to make a starter house, right? Is this a good area to settle in? I don't know. I'm not sure if I like it. I kind of liked it back by the cherry blossom biome where we were. Okay, let's sleep. Day one complete. I really like this area here. This is cool. You know what? We're gonna go right over here. There's so much sugar cane. I am not gonna complain. We're gonna have a full enchanting setup in no time. Sir. Okay, well, I don't know if we need ink sacks for anything, but we have it. We have one now. Ink sack. Ooh, more ink sacks. Yay. I don't know why we need ink sacks, but we need ink sacks. Here, moo-moos. Where are ya? There's so many cows around here. Yes. Come to me. I am going to name all of you eventually. How about Carl? Carl Jr., Carl Sr., and Carl the 5th. Even though there's 4 of you. Alright, so here is the deal. I'm gonna go on a big mining grind, and I think it is going to probably be pretty darn boring for you guys. So I'm going to fast forward, and you guys are gonna be able to watch a beautiful montage. If anything important happens, then I will be back. Are back from our mining trip, and guys, I got so many diamonds. I got 34, which I believe is the exact amount I need to make a full kit of diamond armor and tools, but I'm not gonna do that yet. I am not, in fact, going to do that yet. What I'm gonna do actually is I need to find a lava pit, because I, strangely enough, could not find one while I was down in the mine. What was awesome, though, if you guys could tell from the montage, I was able to get all of those diamonds from a very small cave system. The amount of luck that I have on this seed is insane. I love it. I'm just a little bit bummed that there weren't any books at that village, but that's okay. We'll see if we can find another village somewhere else around here. Oh, hey, there is another village. Let's go, baby. Look what I found. Hello, Mr. Librarian.
2 hours later.
That, my friends, is a mending book. Sweet. No way. Wait, guys, I found it. I found him. Do you see him? It is a pink sheep. You, I'm naming you Jeffrey. Goodbye, Jeffrey. I have found a pit of lava. So I have every piece of obsidian that we need. So let's go make the enchanting table as well as make a nether portal. Here we go. Heck yeah, baby. Alrighty then, let's open up the nether portal and see what's on the other side, shall we? Ooh. Okay, so we have the main biome here, which means there's a very good chance of a nether fortress being nearby, which would be so ideal. I'd love that. So, I got my hands on a mending book, and what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to start making the plans for a house. And my house, I believe, is going to be right over there, right at the base of that hill there in the cherry blossom biome. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to be making a tower, actually. And some of the blocks that I'm thinking about using, I am thinking about using some of this smooth basalt and this deep slate here as well. Probably some cobble and bricks and things like that as well. And I think it's going to look pretty darn good, but we're going to mix some cherry wood in there and some oak. So what I'm going to do is I am going to get efficiency 4, baby, on my diamond axe. And it has unbreaking 3. Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted. Not only that, but I have my mending book. So we're going to go right ahead and slap that on that puppy. Yes. And it's that time again. And by again, I mean I've never done this before. Welcome to Ask Scully. And Ask Scully is going to be a segment that I'm going to do on these episodes where you guys can ask me a question, put it in the comments below, use hashtag Ask Scully, and ask me a question, whether that relates to Minecraft and, you know, in the community and issues that are going on right now or things that you're excited about or whatever it might be. Put it in the comments and you might get picked for me to answer your question. So today, I'm just going to be moving my materials over there. And while I'm doing that, I will answer Pro Wrestling Vid's question. If you could update any biome, what would it be and why? And that is a fantastic question. Thank you very much. That's a hard one. I really, really like the snowy biomes, like a snowy taiga and things like that. And I feel like they don't get enough love. And kind of understandably so, because snow in Minecraft is kind of ugly. It's really pretty, just as bare bones as is. When you walk into a biome, it looks really pretty. But when it lands on top of structures, though, not so much. And I think that's something that Minecraft needs to fix. And there is a mod that somebody has made where whenever snow falls, it does also fall on top of stairs and on top of slabs and fences, and it just makes it look 10 times more pretty. And I feel like just something as simple as that would be a great addition to the game. But, you know, maybe something a little else extra to spruce it up a bit, no pun intended, if you're talking about a taiga. But I think there's things they could do to give it just a little bit of spice. But yes, I would say especially the snowy biomes and just giving them a little bit of love, because I think it would be awesome if people made more homes in snowy biomes. Thank you very much, Pro Wrestling Vids, for the question. So starting with the base of the tower, I'm going to be having the stone colors here, but we're going to be having the darker ones at the bottom to kind of show the little bit of wear and earthiness, and then move up to the lighter grays and even putting in some wool to help break up the color just a little bit. And I think it's going to turn out really, really well. And also to kind of contrast with the darker stones, I'm going to be putting in some birch, which when you look at it from here, it almost looks like a yellow up against stone, and I've never really realized that. Like, this is a very yellow block, even though birch is typically seen as a very just lighter wood. Like, you know what I mean? It's different, and I think it's gonna look really well with the stone. And then on the inside, though, and possibly on the outside, I might do some of it on the outside, is I have these pink blocks. We have the granite, and we have the cherry blossom log and the planks themselves. But I really like these together like this. It has to go with the granite, though. The granite has to be a good accent stone, and I think it's gonna turn out well. And then I'm gonna break that up with spruce and oak and other dark woods as well. You guys will see what that looks like in a moment, because you guys get to watch me build. Let's go. We are back, guys. Look at this tower. Ah, I love it. I love it. So, I'll give you guys the tour. This is just the outside, and I want to do more with it. I want to make additions. So, for instance, over here, we have this stable, and I'm going to have horses in it eventually. So, I want to add possibly another tower on the side here, maybe somewhere for storage. It's just a starter house, it's not the mega base or anything like that, but I do want to just add something onto it. If you guys have any suggestions as to what that might be, let me know in the comments below. So yeah, you can kind of see how the darker stone on the bottom shows a lot of wear, goes up into cobble, and then up into bricks and stone to kind of make up the rest of the tower. And I did end up going with mud for the roofs, and I like it. I like it a lot. And the cherry blossoms as little bits of shrubbery all over the build make it look really cool as well. So we're gonna go into the front door, and I'll show you guys what's going on the inside, which isn't much at all, but I have a lot of room for interior decorating, and I really want to get better at interior decorating. So, if you guys have any suggestions of what I can put in each of the rooms, let me know in the comments below. So, you enter through the door, and there is this spiral staircase going up, and there's a little lobby area down here. And if we go up the stairs, there's nothing. There's just another little balcony area up here. However, I think it would be nice to put in some kind of bridge across the roof of the stable, possibly, and have something over in this direction. Or I could always have a door right here and have something going off into the back of the building, but I'm not exactly sure what I want to do with that just yet. You go up a floor, and it is a small floor up here, a little bit of space, and there's a window looking outwards over here, and you can see my setup over there in the distance. And I had to grow a lot of wheat right here so that could consistently be growing for my mud bricks, because those were a hassle to get. But if we go up to the next level here, it is an even smaller floor with a little bit of a sneak peek of what the top floor is going to look like. I don't think I'm actually going to add anything to this floor in particular. It's just here. It's nice. And let's go up again. And this time it's just a ladder. It's just a little ladder area in the tower. And we go up here, and voila! This is the main bedroom area. Again, it needs interior decorating, and I will do that. But there are these supports that are coming up to the ceiling where I have a redstone lamp providing the light in the room, and windows on three sides of the. Oh, we got a patrol down there. And windows on the three walls in the tower. So, This turned out pretty darn cool. I actually really, really like it. What I would like to do, if possible, is to build a little medieval village in this area here as kind of a side project. And I will probably put some villagers in the area as well. And I would like some suggestions from you guys as to what buildings I should put in, like a blacksmith, and suggestions on what the building could look like, what materials it's made out of, and all sorts of things like that. Funnel me with ideas. This is a brand new canvas of a world for us to build and explore on and build all sorts of new projects. I'm so excited. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we'll clean up this area a bit and make everything look nice, make sure it's lit up and everything. So, yeah, I think this is going to be a ton of fun. So, I think this is going to be the end of the episode. So, just thank you guys very much for watching. This was so much fun. I am so excited to keep continuing this series. But for now, that is it from me. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I will see you all later. Goodbye!